a master practicing his craft.
And you know, I tell him, just like you, you can't do what I do, and I can't do what you do.
So, I'm so glad I found you. You are going to make my holiday, buddy. You know that?
I am so proud and glad
you know that, I'm going to tell everybody in town about you.
Well, now, I tell you, I come this way because I figure I could pick up a customer, too.
Yeah. Well, John, who owns Blue Top in Highland,
right. Mm-hmm.
I saw his windows in some pictures from his Christmas party, and I quick sent him a message, and I said, hey, John, I go, who did your windows? And he gave me your name and number, but he said you were from Cal City, which I'm from Cal City, but no difference. It doesn't matter where you're from. Because I asked in the local pages here, like, who does your guys' windows? And I never really got any response. Uh-huh. So now I got a guy who's going to come here every year, mm-hmm. which is you, and do my windows.
I
owned a storefront. This is the first storefront I've had like this. Uh-huh. And I always, always wanted to do the windows.
Wow.
You know? Okay. I always wanted the windows done.
Well, I tell you, John had a location out there in Maryville. I used to go out there.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. And then he picked me up. I started this about in, I would say, 2000.
Okay.
And what it does, it takes care of me having something to do during the slow part of my season.
What do you normally do?
Science.
Oh, science.
Yeah, yeah.
I see.
Stuff like this.
Yeah.
Truck lettering.
I go. Okay.
We have a sign shop. This is just an addition that I added to it. Like I say, during the slow season, which you know the winter time is slower.
Uh huh.
And it caught on, and I got about, I say, 25 customers. And every year it kind of grows because I pick up new ones.
I'm going to tell everybody about you.
And
I'm going to put this on my YouTube channel.
Okay.
Which, not a lot of local people here, but I'm also going to share it with people in town.
All right.
This, to me, this is an art that no one teaches anymore.
Yeah, no.
You know? Who does this?
About what used to be, man, it is crazy now because with all the technology and all, I'd rather be back in the day. I mean, you know, seriously, I used to hand paint. But now I got a computer, and then I didn't upgrade, but I have a source that I can get anything digital printed and whatever.
Uh-huh.
I know how to install it.
Okay.
You know.
No, this is awesome. I mean, you actually made my holiday.
Oh, man.
You really did, bud.
Well, you know what, John? I am so glad that we met, man. It is.
Yeah. So am I.
Well, like with John, you know, I've been knowing him for a while, and we go back, like I say, I used to go over to Maryville and do his location over there.
How easy is this to come off, Joe? You got a razor blade it?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's it? I usually come back around the 6th.
Oh, you come back to take it off?
Yeah, there's a fee. I charge you about $35.
Yeah. American. Okay, that's fine.
And
This
is an oil-based paint, so it takes a remover to take it off.
Okay.
And would you believe, man, and I know this is not new to you, all the years I've been doing this, I was paying like $20 a gallon, $25 a gallon for the remover.
Uh-huh.
The stuff have doubled.
Yeah.
It cost me $40 a gallon.
Yeah. Well, unfortunately, Joe, a lot of things have doubled.
Oh, man. You know what, man? And I don't think there's no end to it. There's no end.
I think a lot of things have doubled.
I'm going to put you a Merry Christmas. Would you want to change it up? Maybe say season greeting?
You're the artist, my friend. I'm letting your creative juices flow.
I like using the word Christmas because Merry Christmas, because I don't know how we figure we can get past, you know, just because a few people
Yeah.
I
don't understand how come people get bent out of shape about Merry Christmas. I mean.
Oh, man. I mean, you know, over the years after doing this, you know, I make sure that I ask my customer, you know.
Beforehand?
Yeah, because, like I say, there are some people that get offended by it.
Yeah.
It's a crazy thing, but that's.
Unbelievable.
Yes, it is. We live in those times that. Nothing is adding up.
Yeah, old-fashioned people like me and you are becoming dinosaurs.
Distinct. Yeah, you're right.
You know, we're getting to be dinosaurs.
Well, and as I say, I was blessed with this talent, and I discovered it, and I wouldn't trade it for nothing in the world.
Yeah.
You know, it's been as low, as cold as 17 degrees out here doing this. And, I was much younger, so
right.
Now I don't run to do it in that kind of weather because my insurance has told me I'd run.
I gotta ask you, you gotta have the best windows in your neighborhood. Do you do your house?
No.
You don't? Really?
I sure don't. It's just like I read once in a science. In a sign book that I magazine that I used to get, and it said that our sign, being sign painters, would be the worst sign it is because we don't have time to do our own.
Ah, the shoemaker goes barefoot scenario, right?
Yep.
Or the auto mechanic's always driving a leaky car.
Yep.
Oh man.
But I do enjoy it.
Yeah.
You can see it can be fun and just meeting new people.
Yeah. It's gotta be great when it's snowing just a little bit, but it's not super, super cold, you know.
Right, well now as I say, as long as I got overhang,
you're good.
I can operate.
Right.
Because this is an oil base. Everything except the white that I use for my Santa Claus snowman, they are, that's a water base.
I gotcha. Yeah.
As long as I can get it on before the water contact, you know.
If you're like sub-zero, does it bother you to do that? Does that paint stick?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah? Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I had to order the other day a gallon of paint. Because for whatever reason, China got the ingredients on this paint that I use. And I finally found some. I mean, if you could tell me what a gallon of red paint cost me, I'd do this free.
Yeah. Well, I know red is the most expensive color because I have a red race car.
Right.
Okay. And I remember painting it in the 80s. I almost fell over of the price of that. So I would say a gallon of red paint, I'm going to say $150.
Louis John, you're off about $100.
Oh, wow.
Well, that's because it's a shortage. This is designed, this paint is designed especially for sign. It has a different flow.
Okay.
If I was using paint from Menards or whatever, it doesn't flow like this paint.
Yeah.
It has a flow that no other paint does it. And when you're doing this, you definitely need a flow. You don't need to.
Exactly. Have you ever passed this on to anyone, Joe?
You mean?
You know, showed someone how to do that? Someone younger or no?
Man, if you tell me somebody that's willing. And this is a
kids are different today, ain't they?
I'm telling you, man. And I mean, with me, I'm eager. I'm going to suck up everything I can. And yeah. I know you're doing transmission, and I know that's about one of the most about a vehicle because of it has so many components.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And I used to have a guy with me, and the only thing he wanted to do was get paid.
That's the true today, my friend.
But you really can't. I don't You got to have something about you to do this. You can't teach this.
Yeah.
You have to want this.
Yeah.
And you, and with wanted, you already got some ability to do it.
If you have the desire and the drive.
That's what I want to say, desire.
The desire,
yes.
Then you'll become the best at anything.
That's it.
You really will. You'll become the best at anything.
Well, for whatever reason, I had the opportunity to work with a couple of guys when I was coming up. I went to California thinking that I was going to be able to get into Disney. Art program, but I just wasn't skilled enough. In Orlando, at Disney World, they have a city underground down there. Everything is produced right there on site.
Okay.
They have a studio, and every time I would get the opportunity, I would go there. And man, to see those guys roll, it kind of scared me to even want to go in there. I mean, you know. I'm serious. In Orlando, everything, that whole place underground, you could get lost down there. It's just like downtown in Chicago where...
Lower Wacker Drive.
Yeah.
We were just there.
Yeah. And it did the same thing. But those guys, man, they scared me. I had no college degree in this. So all of it is, you know, me taking it on.
Now, same here.
I was mesmerized one time by... seeing this guy, they was opening up a service station. The name of the station was Fill Up with Bill Up. This was in Mississippi. And I couldn't have been no more than about 6 years old. And I saw this guy in this scaffold, and he was painting his hand. And it was a hand just like this.
Uh-huh.
Thumbs up like this. And I watched that guy. From then on, I was just amazed by what he did.
Really?
Yeah.
And no kidding.
With this.
Wow, what a great story.
Wow.
My father had a transmission shop in Calumet City, and he taught me the trade.
Okay.
So that's how I got into doing what I do.
Okay. Well, I think mostly, you know, you got to, like you say, a desire. You got to have that desire.
Yep, you do.
If you don't have that desire, you're not going to... You know,
all the college in the world is not going to help you.
That's it. Well, like I say, college wasn't for me. I had 2 years and I got out.
Yeah.
I left and, like I said, I went to California, Florida.
Okay.
Because I had a brother down there and he worked for Disney and he got me in. And, again, I say I never applied for it because I think fear kind of set in there. I was only about 18 years old. Fear set in there just watching those guys. I can't.
Oh.
But I should have took the chance. Somebody might have taken me under their wings.
Yeah.
And taken me.
Yeah.
Another
yeah. Level. Yeah.
Because everything has a. What I want to say.
A mentor.
Well, no, everything has but either way, I truly believe that the story I told you about the man and me seeing him paint, that
yeah, just hit. That's funny, that stuck with you forever.
Yeah.
You know?
And my parents, my father was a farmer, so we didn't...
And did you grow up here in Indiana?
No, I grew up in Mississippi.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Marks, Mississippi, down in the Delta. I know you heard of casino down there in Tunica, Mississippi.
Okay.
It wasn't, it was all over. They started popping up, John, and them people came down there and sent all those people either to the graveyard or to the poorhouse.
Oh, really?
There was people going over there, farmers going over there, losing so much money they killed themselves on the way back home.
Wow.
I know two instances. But again, I caught on. And I've been going ever since.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas.